Hello everyone, I am Manisha Mehta, your own clinical dietitian and sports nutritionist, and you are on my channel Renourish with Manisha. We are here making fitness easy for foodies. And today we are going to discuss about cravings. Why do they happen and exactly what we can do to fix them? So if you are also one of those people who constantly crave for cookies or something sweet or something fried, then keep on watching. And before we start the video, I would like to thank the supporters of this channel from last week. Thank you so much guys for helping me spread my message to everyone. And if you also want to help me in my agenda of taking simplified fitness to everyone, then take a screenshot of this video and share it on your social media, on your Facebook, on your Instagram, and do not forget to tag me. Now, without wasting any time, let's get started with the food cravings. The dictionary says that craving is a powerful desire of something. And in this video, we are discussing the powerful desire of consuming a food product. I think we all will agree that at some point or the other, we have craved for something at least. It can be a chocolate, it can be a cake, it can be something fried. But want to know where these cravings come from? So just like my age-old habit, I am going to go into the nitty-gritties of science to explain you why this is happening. There are majorly two hormones which are responsible for our hunger and our satiety, which are leptin and ghrelin. Ghrelin is released by our digestive tract or the stomach, and that tells our brain that the stomach is empty, so probably it's time to eat something. And on the other hand, there is leptin, which is released by our fat cells, and it tells our brain that we can stop eating now because we have had enough. Now I'm going to dive into different components which contribute to a disbalance in the leptin and ghrelin levels so that you understand the science behind it and you can rectify it on your own. Let's first talk about the daily little cravings that we have after the dinner or after the lunch. As I have told you in this video and this video over here, that there is a minimum amount of calories that you're supposed to have on an everyday basis, even if you're not working out. If you drop your calorie intake below that level, then your brain will tell you to give those calories for the proper normal functioning of the body. So imagine at the end of the day, your brain is calculating how many calories you have eaten throughout the day and there is 200 calories less than required. Then what will happen is that your brain will tell you, boss, a little bit of calories are left for the day. Can you please go and eat something? But since it is almost time to sleep, that is the reason why you can't even have a very heavy amount of food. So you will crave for something which will give you more calories in lesser volume. And where will that come from? Either sweet or fried. So this is the reason why these are the two major kind of cravings which we have. And that is the reason why you always go for that piece of chocolate after the dinner, or you go for that piece of small cake, because these are the foods which are going to give you a lot of calories in a very little quantity of food. So the easiest thing that you can do to avoid the cravings is that you eat properly in the day. Please listen to your body, and I cannot emphasize this enough. Your body will tell you exactly what it needs. You just have to listen to it. Second, there is something called as adaptive thermogenesis. Adaptive thermogenesis is defined as the regulated production of heat in response to environmental changes in temperature and diet, resulting in metabolic inefficiency. Now let's just break down this definition in a very, very simple manner. Imagine there is a friend of yours who is constantly poking you to talk, but you keep shushing them. Then do you expect them to keep coming back to you and talking to you? No, right? This is the same thing, similar thing happening inside the body. When ghrelin is released in the body, that's when you start feeling hungry. That's when your body will come and tell you that you need to eat something. But in the pursuit of sticking to a diet or losing weight, you do not eat enough, then your body is trying to adapt to the change, because in a way you are shushing your body every time it is coming you with a hunger signal. That's when your body will actually reduce the demand also, because the supply is not there. Remember in this video I told you how our body still behaves like early man? So imagine yourself as an early man itself. If you're hungry and you're not able to eat, then this early man body will still think that you are not able to eat because the food is not available. So in the pursuit of adapting to whatever the situation you might be in, your body will reduce the demand also. So that's when the level of ghrelin will drop and leptin will rise, so that you do not feel much hungry. But if we talk about the problem with this approach, There are researchers who have proven that if people are on a low calorie diet for a very, very long time, then their leptin and ghrelin levels remain disbalanced for a very, very long time. This is again one of the many reasons why you should not be going on a low calorie diet. And yes, even if you want to lose weight, even then you do not need to go on an extremely low calorie diet. You will get a lot of answers about fat loss in this video over here. So I would urge you to go and have a look at this. Second reason why the cravings go beyond a level is also very, very common. Have you ever done this before, that you're supposed to go for a celebration and you know that you are going to have some nasty food over there, and to compensate for that, you will stop eating throughout the day so that you do not go overboard with the calories of the day? That's when you are actually disbalancing your ghrelin, because you haven't eaten throughout the day properly. That's why in the evening, when you are supposed to be at that junk food parade, your ghrelin levels will be over the roof, and that's when you will overeat as well, and then you will regret. And let's be honest, if we are really hungry, we are not going to go looking for a healthier option out of all the choices. A better way is that you keep eating throughout the day normally, so that whenever the junk food is in front of you, you also can keep sane and then have it to the level of enjoyment rather than to the level of guilt. And besides, in this whole approach of low calorie and compensating for calories, I want to ask everybody this one thing. Since when did staying half hungry become normal? I don't think that weight loss is something worth punishing your body for. Third and very important is the role of sleep in the maintenance of leptin and ghrelin. Remember in this video, I told you about how stress and sleep are connected? It is found that sleep and appetite is also connected. If you're not making the most of your circadian rhythm, then you will end up disbalancing your leptin and ghrelin levels, and that's when the cravings will arise. I hope you have understood the real reasons for cravings, and whatever research papers I have discussed here, they are linked in the description below. So I would urge you to go and read that. Otherwise, I have already given you the gist of it. But next comes what we can do about the cravings. First, very obvious, never go on a low calorie diet. Do not try to compensate for the calories that you're eating. It's okay if you have eaten a little more. It's okay that you are going for an occasion. But that does not give you a reason to stay hungry throughout the day. Because as I've already told you, if you stay hungry for long, then when you eat, there is a massive chance that you will be eating a nasty amount of junk food. Second, sleep properly. I cannot emphasize enough what is the importance of sleeping in sync with the sun cycle or the circadian rhythm. In this video, I have discussed this in detail, but to give you a gist of it, we have to sleep within 3 to 4 hours of the sunset, because that's the time when our body repairs itself optimally. So the ideal time for repair is around 10:30, 11 p.m. to say 2-3 a.m. And that's what we need to make the most of. Third, watch your diet closely. If you are craving for a specific food item again and again, there is a high chance that it might be because of some nutrient deficiency as well. For example, if you are craving for something sweet, then there is a high chance that you are lacking protein in your diet. If you are craving for breads, then there is a chance that you are deficient in vitamin B12. In the description box, I am giving you a list of food cravings which relate to a specific nutrient deficiency and where or in what foods you can find that nutrient. So I would suggest you that you go into the description box and download that PDF. Fourth, if you have eaten enough, if you do not have a pattern in your cravings and still in once in a while you are craving for something, then please go ahead and have it. Because we are here to enjoy life, and food is a big part of enjoying life, right? Enjoying food and enjoying what body is asking for is also a way of respecting the body and listening to the body. And on that note, Manisha Mehta signing off. I will see you next week. Until then, be a fit foodie and always remember, I love you unconditionally. Bye!